Name the biggest problem that you've run into in the first bidding process. And the second thing to do is tell me some of the things that you're able to correct the major problems. And in order, what's the biggest difference between the first bidding process and the second bid process? So first of all, tell me the biggest problem that you've had in the first bidding process.
The biggest problem that I think we had was with the tool that we use to interface with suppliers in the process, and that was the online bidding system. There were problems with the online bidding system that caused a lot of frustration for suppliers. Again, bids were submitted electronically. Hard copy documentation followed later, but bids were submitted electronically. The system would time out. The system would lose information. That was a problem that we had to deal with. We have taken that issue and for round two developed an entirely new system that we expect will not have those types of problems. That was a concern, caused us to have to extend the bid window, and again, caused suppliers a lot of frustration. So I think that's sort of to the point that we are now, the biggest thing that we want to do for the next round of competitive bidding. The other thing I'd add is that supplier education is always a key issue. To the extent that you have a new program, you have lots of suppliers across the country, you want to be transparent on the rules. We want to work on education, learn from round one, where did people have concerns, where were their problems in the bid, and focus our education on those issues. And then finally, I think the last thing I'd mention is we are just now moving forward with a big national beneficiary education program in the 10 areas, and I think we're looking at that to see how that works, where we might need to make changes for next time. That's one of the key parts of this endeavor, educating the beneficiaries and those that refer beneficiaries for services.
Is CMS completely prepared for the July second bidding process?
Well, we have not announced a timeline for the second bidding process. We have not said that we're going to open the bid window in July. Okay. I think what we are doing right now is concentrating on round one in the 10 areas and ensuring that we are prepared to implement the system, meet beneficiary needs, and monitor to ensure that beneficiaries get what they need. That's what we're focused on now. I think in the coming weeks or months, we will publish a timeline, specific timeline for round two, so that suppliers will know what they need to do to get ready for round two.
Obviously, being a part of the Blue Dog Caucus, you know, we're very concerned about wasteful spending and being able to cut areas of wasteful spending in our budget when we're at a tremendous debt in our nation's history we're passing along to our children and grandchildren. So, I commend CMS from the standpoint of being able to save money. What has been the overall value of savings? And the reason I caution when I ask this question, just the initial savings from the standpoint of, from the supplier standpoint, but let's say, for instance, they're dropping off the equipment at a drop-off at a location. Say it's home oxygen care. They drop it off. Well, if they're not being able to regulate it and being able to manage it and have the case management with that particular patient, how many of those patients ultimately end up in the emergency room? Ambulance ride, $600 ambulance ride. How many of those? So was that in evaluating in the equation of the overall cost, was that taken in consideration? How much savings were there in round one?
I don't know if that type of factor was that type of qualitative factor was evaluated in round one. I'm not sure how it would be. I think the thing that we have tried to do to address the issue overall, which would seem to me to mitigate the financial impact or the economic impact of that type of
loss of jobs, unemployment, layoffs. I mean, all those have to be taken in consideration. You just can't look at the complete one implication that when you say we have a bidding process and we're going to be able to save money in the initial cost, when in fact more people are going to the emergency room, more people are getting an ambulance ride, more people are staying in the hospital, and ultimately more causes of healthcare costs to rise. I mean, those have to be taken in consideration. The loss of jobs from our small businesses have to be taken in consideration. How many people went from a company of 10 to a company of 2? How many because they're subcontractors now, not the initial providers? I mean, all of those have to be taken in consideration for us to be, as members of Congress, to help you with CMS to be able to help regulate. I'm all for doing everything that we can to make sure that we provide the quality of service has to be number one for the patient, but we also have to make sure that we manage it in the fact that we have the quality, but we cut spending as best we possibly can. And I think that all of us agree, on the committee would agree, we have to do something with our health care problem, but we can't provide more at cost and just as a pass along to other industries, because it ultimately is going to come down to the cost. And if we're not careful, then we're going to bankrupt our country. This health care problem. And at this time, I'll yield to the ranking member, Mr. Fortenberry, for his questions.